Ever have a dream you can't quite shake? It's called a vision. And Queen Allison had a nasty one. Her father's soul was torn from paradise and dragged into the underworld. Allison called for a hero to champion her. But only one responded. Tarnos.
Huh. We're playing his castle now? Alright, so conquest of the underworld. The ancestors send Tarnum to help Queen Allison rescue the soul of her father from the depths of the underworld. But the demons are undead. But the demons and undead are the least of his worries when Tarnum faces his past crimes. Oh. Cerberus Gate. Tarnum must reach the underworld gate and defeat the devils below to secure passage into the underworld. You must not lose Tarnum. All heroes will be limited to level 6, but Tarnum and two of his captains will transfer to the next scenario with all of their skills, spells, and experience. And we either get the gloves or the boots. Alright, I'll take the gloves. Actually, I'll take the boots. Usually the boots end up better. And let's begin.
When the ancestors sent Tarnum to protect Queen Allison as she embarked on a dangerous quest into the underworld, he learned that the ancestors had not forgotten his crimes. Was this his punishment? To save the soul of the man who killed him?
Damn. That's deep right there. Alright, let's see what you guys are saying real quick. Hey, Gwernaroth, welcome to the stream. Hey, Yellinger, how's it going? Which scenario was the last one? Castle Steelhorn. Finished it. Castle Baby! Yes! My favorite faction! Here we go! It's Stannis time, boys! The ancestors have summoned me to the kingdom of Arathiota to help young Queen Allison, who had a dream that her father's soul was stolen from paradise and taken down into the darkness of the underworld. I've seen the faces of her knights and realized that I am the only one brave enough to come to her aid against the forces of the underworld. But I've also come to realize that the ancestors have a truly twisted sense of humor. They want me to rescue the soul of the man who killed me. If it were not for Rion Griffinheart, I might still be alive today. If I had more time, perhaps I would have come to my senses and ended my tyranny. I realize now that I was wrong, and I must believe that if given enough time, I would have been able to correct the sins I committed while King of the Barbarians. The same sins that made me unworthy of entering paradise. You can never get away from killing Hardak! Oh, new portrait. Tarnum, he's a knight. Judged by the ancestors as unworthy of entering paradise, Tarnum wanders the land, seeking redemption for the crimes of his past. He's the immortal hero, a timeless protector, but eventually troubled by the doubt that he can ever make up for the tremendous wrongs he performed in his youth. Oh, he's got Stannis' specialty! Wait! Does that mean we can't use Stannis? Oh no! Stannis is the one true ancestor. Stannis. Oh, no way. No monks! That guys, they knew how OP monks were. We can't use them. Dun dun dun. Uh-oh. No. Let's set this. There we go. That sounds about right. And no show here reminder. And hope I remember to adjust the combat speed as well. And look at that. Mines are actually guarded now. Been a while since we've seen that. And welcome to the club. And welcome to the club. Alright, well, we're off to a great start. Doesn't feel like we're underground, though. I guess we're not. Rion Grivenheart's name is not new to me. He was the first king of Arathia, an upstart nation that challenged my authority as king of the land. After years of vicious combat, Griffinheart was able to maneuver me into a battlefield of his choosing. I can still smell the mud. I still remember my enemy's face as he plunged his sword through my belly. It's unfair of the ancestors to force me to save this man. Is he really innocent? He's not even a barbarian. Let Griffinheart's soul rot in the underworld, for all I care. It's Curl. I didn't get him a spellbook, did I? Sorry, the spells I got in there, I would hope I will get later on as well. Ooh, look at that. Gold mine. Mine! This is my gold! Go away and find your own, you greedy humans. And they want to join us. Well, I'll fight. Hey, Xylorin, this is Chapter 2 of Heroes Chronicles, Conquest of the Underworld. Throng of Bikemen 111. This is Cable Strats, boys. Gnome Monks, I know, we're screwed. Okay, hold on. There we go. Thank you. That's everything. Actually, use a Cursor Shadow. Get away from our gold! We'll join ya! I don't think I should use the Curse of Shadow. There we go, that seems much better. Sorry about the delay. But look at this. Now we actually get OP Ballistas again. We can control the Ballista. Stopping for a quick break, you wander into the shadows of a cool forest. Immediately you stumble upon a majestic bird, shimmering with all the colors of the rainbow. You stop in your tracks. Your legs won't move. This is the famed Quaybird, more beautiful than any creature as you have ever seen. It peers at you, looking straight into your soul. With a sudden start, the magnificent bird lifts off, leaving a sparkling blue feather behind. You pick up the feather and the men take this as a good omen, raising their morale significantly. And then we got them a gold mine, and the morale raised for Arthur. And then we faced Marksman, and we got set. Thank you for the host, Slade the Black Mage. Shoot them. No. Come on. My Griffins definitely got the first move last time. It's the only reason I didn't shoot them. Alright, we're off to a great start, I guess. Hi there. Here at the border to the underworld, this land is dangerous to travel. Not far to the north is an inferno town that has been harassing Arathian troops and citizens for decades. There's only one way to handle such a pest. Build a good-sized army and attack them as quickly as possible. Defeated enemy can't hurt you. I agree. And there are two enemies, okay. And there they are. Damon Gale. Hey, Kribble. Welcome to the stream. Bye for 18 minutes. Yep. Of course not. Oh, we're back to weak Tarnum. God damn. There we go. And yes, let's take Wisdom. Wasn't offered enough in the last one. Haste and slow. Alright. We are already off to a far better start than we had last time. Let's go Copyre. And down she goes. And blue has been vanquished. Alright, off to a great start. Yep. Yep. We're doing good. We're doing good. I like it. I approve. Heaps of treasure and resources are simply lying about in the ground, so I've decided to concentrate on building the troop generation dwellings right now, rather than concentrating on structures such as the town hall. Of course, my advisors agree this tactic is wise. So we're back to telling me what to do, even though I'm already doing it. Alright. I say that this is a great start. Yeah, I'd say it's a pretty good start. Pretty good looking Tarnum already. Throw some air magic and logistics in there, and offense, and pretty good start. Feels good, man. Seriously. Excellent, sir. We were just on our way to tell you that we are interested in joining your cause. If you visit the barracks weekly, we'll be very glad to sign up with you, says a swordsman, pointing to the barracks just behind him. Wow, game, I didn't know that's how it worked. Oh no. Go away, this mercury is for our master, so we can't let you have it. Well, at least these imps were loyal and didn't try to join us like the troglodytes. Nice army there, game. Nice army. Seven whites. We want proof that you are indeed fighting for the side of good. Bring us seven whites so we can destroy them. That's what Sandro said. It's literally what Sandro said. Bring me these so I can destroy it. Lying people. It may be wiser to ignore piles of treasure near a mine and get the mine under production as quickly as possible, says one of your advisors. There is always time later on to pick up treasure, unless, of course, there are enemies about. Also, you should hire another hero to help you. We can be attacked from both east and west, and another hero to protect the flanks is needed. So that's, that looked pretty good to me. Clover of Fortune. I bet that's in here somewhere. 11 Royal Griffins. There you go. And that'll take us that way. Alright, so we need 11 Royal Griffins. No. This will allow us to get 11 Royal Griffins right here, right now. Bring some white so we can destroy the braces. Hey Zolta, welcome to the stream. Exactly, Slay the Black Mage, exactly. Fair enough, Zolta. Nice little key-ish. Mm-hmm. None shall pass here, is that so? Hey there, Rose. You can barely believe your eyes as you approach the gold mine. Ahead, a pack of skeletons busily fill carts with gold. As you approach, though, they drop their tools and pick up swords. "Stay away!" they shout. "We didn't hand over this mine when we died, so we're certainly not going to do it now." And then they were willing to flee. And upgrade them. Serve them. I don't want the capital there, I'll build that in my own town. Who's in the tavern? Not Stannis. It'd be a real shame if we couldn't play as Stannis. Who needs Stannis when you have Tarnum? I want him. Got him in the last one. That's the third time! This is the third time we've gotten a min. And we only had three Griffin cons in this campaign. Good, attack them. No, not them, not them! And we win. And That's one Andrew the Angel. I should have probably taken Archery to be perfectly honest. I think that would be fun to use. What wonderful news! Now we can fly away to safety on the back of these 11 Royal Griffins and he doesn't have an army! I just realized he doesn't have an army now! We did it! We broke the game! Am I ill? I think I'm just coming down with something. These cons seem pretty foul to me. Well, we did it! Cuthbert has no army! Now, I do believe they fixed that in the HD mod. I think that was one of those things they fixed. But yep, no army on Cuthbert! I really do wonder what would happen if we started that fight. So much so, though, let's do it. It's an automatic defeat! Attacker, no losses. That was funny. Just up and said, screw this. We're supposed to be watching this place and keeping all you peoples from getting to the Sulphur Dune. Always the big ones ordering us around. We're gonna get to order nobody. Wanna be home in bed, but nobody cares. Not you either, I bet. Well, someone's gotta pay. You're giving me a brain aneurysm at 10 in the morning. That was worth Cuthbert's life. That was definitely worth Cuthbert's life. That's the end of that. God damn it, Sulphur's not spelled with like that. Fucking British HD mod. Well, glad to see we already had some fun with this. Rion Griffinheart is always on my mind these days. After he slaughtered me, he was able to have a family and lead his kingdom into greatness. Griffinheart was responsible for the destruction of my empire, a barbarian empire, and for scattering my people back into the inhospitable western lands. And now the ancestors are favoring this outsider. Is not Griffinheart responsible for weakening our people? He's an enemy, and yet I must save him. I just don't understand it. I feel some character growth. Never saw that bug before. I've seen it before, but only after, like, a fight where I won using elementals and then had to use basic resurrection to survive it. I've never seen me able to trade the units. Alright, so they only have this one town? I feel like there's supposed to be so much more to this scenario. Could I just go through here? That kind of defeats the purpose. And let's attack. 25 hellhounds. Impossible to keep zero army. No, I mean, I knew it was possible. I've never done it with a quest card. Hey, JWC, welcome to the stream. Got lucked out there. Those angels are probably really close to death. Alright, so let's get back to the town. Queen Allison's messenger arrives and hands me a sealed letter. It reads, "Dear Sir Tarnum, I hope that things are going well, and you find the town of Meddington to be satisfactory. Please hurry. The passing of each day is one more that my father's soul is tortured. If you are in need of anything, please just let me know." She expects a response, I'm sure, but I just don't feel like writing today. Maybe tomorrow. He's back! He's back! Right, you know what, Tarnum? Just for coming back, I'll let you live. Hey, Blood Tears, welcome to the stream. Damn. Oh, yeah, I played it for 16. It's coming on 17 now. Game kind of feels like Age of Wonders. I've been told that a lot, never actually played it myself, though. Hey, Pudic. Yep, late again.
Defuse, and it wasn't even me.
Guthrie died with zero army because he went back and got more. Yep. Yep, went back and got more. All according to plan. The prophecies have been fulfilled. Dun 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 dun. Oh yeah, the Clover Fortune. So I guess the Clover Fortune is up in their zone. Army. How's he on movement? He actually still has quite a bit, so. Let's return to the north and invade. Thanks for the host, Pudic. Cuthbert, back to business, thug life! Hey, you know, Rose, when I uploaded this to YouTube, they said it was HD, so, come at me. You stare bleakly at the inhospitable land ahead. It's burned and scarred by lava and flame. Dead. What twisted creature would choose to live in such a place? The underworld will be worse, you're sure, but this is bad enough. Your men begin to murmur about the strange occurrences that go on in these parts. Evil things.
They fidget as they walk, flinch at every noise. Sensing they are
close to fleeing, you sit boldly in your saddle and show no sign of distress as you give the order to continue. Dun dun. My response to Queen Allison may be late, but it's to the point. Queen Allison, I am doing well and should have access to the gate within a few weeks. I will let you know. You're as good as me, Kicks. Hey, I said thank you. Looks clean now. Yeah, man. Anything is HD if it comes from Twitch, apparently. It was definitely not as salty, for which I am appreciative. What I have is for Tarnum alone, I shall give it to no other, and there's the Clover of Fortune. Well, that makes sense. That actually does make sense. Alright, let's go deliver the Clover of Fortune. I'll worry about the last one if it gets to that. Look at all those spells. Blind in this Mage Guild as well? Dude, this Mage Guild is lit. If only we had Advanced Wisdom, I could go for Town Portal. Wow, you found it for me. How wonderful. No more black cats or mirrors or ladders. I'm going to take my first vacation and enjoy myself. Bravo. Hey, 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 hey. Better not have that red border guard. Whites! Are those the seven? Oh no, those are wraiths. What the hell they get? Oh, I don't know. Right, oh, okay. I can only assume that's their town. Oh, here it is, here it is. Cuthbert, get in here. Gotta get over there, my friend. I don't want gogs, but I do want whites. Alright, so they should be trapped down here. Today is the anniversary of my death and subsequent fall from grace. As I think about it, I realize that it was foolish of me to challenge him in single combat. Ryan Griffinheart was the better swordsman. I wonder what my life would have been like if I had simply ordered my army to attack. Reach level 6, and I get the Ring of Life. Ooh, we're only a level away. Just went there already. There! We need 7 of them. I believe that's only 1 week's worth, so that's fine. And there's Meekix's auto host. This mage guild is lit! Well, yeah, it's Inferno, yeah. Well, hey. Let me just make sure this is cat. Oh, it's defeat monster! Oh, so I can take this. Ah, screw you, AI. Don't mind if I do. Forward. And you're dead. Expert artillery. Instead of wisdom, but we'll get that eventually. Beware. We have them. We have the 7 whites. We have Snow Whites and their 7 dwarves. And it's Valeska and Caitlin, the two heroes I actually do want to carry over to the next scenario. Sorry, Cuthbert. Hey, they didn't take this. States would help your economy in later scenarios. I think we'll be fine. I mean, this tournament is getting a far better build than the Barbarian one. Every time. And we won. Alright. Go! Another message arrives from Queen Allison. Because of your successes, Sir Tarnum, the monks and zealots of the land are convinced that you are performing a service of goodness and will be joining you on the next leg of your journey. If duty did not keep me here, I would be slaying those vile demons myself. Good luck. I chuckle at her words. So she imagines herself a warrior, does she? Well, I guess I have to admire her spirit. It's Pyre again. I already defeated Pyre. This passive is scholar. Situationally useful. Gotcha. Nice. Oh wait. Monks and Zealots, finally! In the next scenario though, not this one. If I read that right. Oh, come on. I was really banking on them not, you know, getting there. Down they go. Down they go. And down they go. And down they go. Take that. So if you notice, the Kreegans were underground the whole time, according to Heroes 3 lore. And there's the glorious victory. for a glorious man. Don't even upgrade to Rose Cavaliers. We can't build monks in this one, though. It's in the next one, I believe. I read that, right? Down goes Nymus. No, Blood Tears, no you are not. Dave is by far the greatest Heroes 3 player out there. And down goes Khalid, and down goes Purple! Give us the whites so we can put their souls to rest, and we'll let you pass. I'm sure you want to visit that tent just to the south of here. Watch for guardians, though. We aren't positive, but some of those demon types might have slipped by us. Well, you had a good life, Cuthbert. Your barbarian instincts tell you that the demons would not leave this place unguarded. You see nothing at first, but the faintest odor of sulfur, see, they spot it right there, gives away the presence of your attackers. They must have seen something in your expression because lots of Magog suddenly attack. And now Cuthbert has fallen. It's fine, I was just gonna dismiss him anyway. Well, then go follow Dave and watch him when he streams. I command you. Reach level 6, you got it. Purple earns the most gold, do they now? Plus one spell power, plus all those spells. Allison has sent a letter almost every day, each one stating her desire to run her sword through the bellies of the evil creatures of this realm. She could almost be a barbarian, except she is too far she's far too concerned about what people think about her. All this letter writing has taught me one thing, though. I hate it and dread every moment behind the pen. Oh. Plus 6 knowledge, alright. Glad I waited. Ah, yeah, I do have to go and get that, don't I? Oh, what the hell? Well, I'll go this way first. Masquerading as a knight isn't all that different from being a barbarian. For the most part, both are honorable and believe in respecting and protecting their families. Verathia used to be barbarian territory, and a large part of the population are descendants of my people. Knights and their society are just a polished version of a barbarian, although knights seem to put the word of their lord above the needs of their community. Just the opposite is true for a barbarian. Well, for a barbarian who follows the old ways. These days, my culture is far more chaotic and violent than they used to be. I wonder why! Poisoned Hardak. I still will never forgive Tarnum for that. Alright. will be avenged. Avenged. All the earth magic. Yeah, man. Earth magic done. Slow done. Town portal, all that's left. Plus 6 of knowledge. Ayy. And now I can finally pass through there. G'day, eagle. Pack of horned demons? What? Did you think we were just going to hand over this gold? That's just about the funniest thing I've heard all year. Is this the... No, I gotta fight through that garrison. That one angel's so lonely, they'll get over it. Hey, Gandalf. Welcome to the stream. It's Tarnum. Wait, no, it's Stannis! This is not Stannis, this is Tarnum. Stannis would never kill Hardak. A little leprechaun dances gleefully around a magic sack. Sack. Seeing you approach, he stops in mid-stride. The little man screams and stamps his foot ferociously, vanishing into thin air. Remembering the old leprechaun saying, "Finders, keepers," you grab the sack and leave. And now I believe I can go and fight this. Yep. Winding your way through the mountains, you see signs of habitation. Old campfires, bones of consumed animals. Too late, you realize that you are surrounded. Gogs attack! They must be protecting the entrance to the underworld. Tarnum killed his sister with bloodlust, though. Stannis killed Renly because it was his only choice. And a garrison. Easy fight. Only Hoda's bad enough. You're playing Wayfarer on it. And into the underworld. You know that deep within the bowels of the earth, demonic forces lay in wait to tear you limb from limb. Before entering such a world, it would be most prudent to have a well-armed force at your back. I can only assume that that's the end of the scenario. Before continuing, you remember your promise to Queen Alison and dispatch a letter stating that you have made it to the Underworld Gate and are just now securing the passage. All that's left are some Archdevils, and you're certain that your army can handle them. Okay. And this is where we save, and then spam the end turn button to make sure we read everything. And there it is. Last night I could hear some young soldiers talking to their sergeant around a campfire. The subject was barbarians. A deep sense of shame overwhelmed me as I listened to the tales. Those barbarians will raid any village, says the sergeant, even ones without any warriors. They plunder and pillage everything in their path. Nothing but mindless savages, I tell you. The only good thing about a barbarian is they kill their own people about as often as they kill us. Unable to listen to any more, I retired early and tried unsuccessfully to convince myself that the soldier was wrong. He's not wrong. Killing the evil creatures of the underworld feels like a chance to atone for all the innocents I've killed while I was the Barbarian King. Is this why the ancestors sent me here? To destroy evil? The Underworld Gate is near. All this effort just to keep... Just to enter the underworld, I shudder to imagine what things are going to be like when I go below into the dark realm itself. If Ryan Griffinheart's soul is there, I'll find it. I swear. I can see that being the end. Yeah, I'm not surprised that's the last one. Alright. No. And now we go and load up that save. Since we've read all this, I forgot they actually changed the pictures. Wouldn't it be handy to split the marksman into two stacks? It would, but the pain of doing so here is just ridiculous. An easy fight for those 9 dead halberdiers. Well, fine, they're dead. Suddenly, Legion Devils. Nah, it's only 7. dun, dun. And we won. Yep. Killed the fearsome beast, and the path is open.